All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, get ready. We're here at the Roy and Jimmy thing. Get ready to rock, get ready to roll. The moment you've all been waiting for. We got hot, sexy Roy and Jimmy. Hell yeah.
Pieces like you always do. Hey, Monday night, Roy and Jimmy thing here on chaoticradio.com. My name is Roy Brewster. This is...
I am Jimmy Shots. Monday night, your Monday night guys right here on chaoticradio.com. The Roy and Jimmy thing, we call it.
Yeah, I mean, it was pretty obvious why.
Okay, good night.
Good night. Thank you, Rancho Cucamonga. That was my mic drop. Jimmy just throws the thing away. Oh, man. Here we are Monday night again, all ready to rock. Hey, new thing tonight. You can watch us live streaming if you'd like. Get a search. I'm going to put up a link right now. It's kind of weird. I'm watching myself, but it's a little late, so I feel like I'm like in a bad dream.
You're used to that, watching yourself?
Oh, I thought you meant I was used to being in a bad dream.
Okay, we'll go with both. But yeah, YouTube.com, search Chaotic Radio. And a live feed will be right there. So there are, you guys are being watched. We see every move.
Yeah, you can't do this. I used to pick my nose. No one knew do stupid stuff. Now I got to like, what if P's and Q's? I was going to have to watch my P's and Q's. But I don't know P's and Q's. What does P and Q stand for?
I don't know.
We got to look that up.
P's and Q's.
Come on, man. Man, how was your week, brother?
Oh, not bad. Nice normal week. How about yourself?
Pretty normal. There was a lot of stuff I wanted to talk about the week. You know, you do that during the week where you're like, okay, wait till Monday night, I don't want to talk about this. Wait till Monday, and you do things like you should write it down, but I don't. And it comes to Monday night. How was your week? Yeah, you know, I was breathing, and I would live to be another week old, and that's about it.
I'll usually think of something when I have nothing to write it down with. And then I'll think, oh, I'll remember. And,
oh, yeah.
You know, it's gone in an hour.
Remember? Whatever.
Gone in an hour.
It's gone like faster than that. It's like a couple minutes later. I'm like, oh shit. Sorry, a little frazzled right now. You know, I had a little headache after work. Figured I'd take a little nap. I'm usually here by 7. Usually here by 8:20-ish.
Yeah.
Yeah. I walked up outside. Everyone's here, going, "Hey, look, Roy's here." It's like 2:00.
Almost asleep through.
Almost asleep. Man. So, anything else? Nothing at all. You didn't do anything this weekend?
No, nothing. Just cutting shows for our morning replays every Monday through Friday here on chaoticradio.com, 6 to 8 a.m. for your morning drive time, with a nice little personal intro from moi and voix.
Yeah, hey, even nailing the weather.
It's pretty close.
This morning, I was off 6 degrees.
Well, you know, from the last 3 days of being 90s and high 90s, right. You know, you thought you'd be in the ballpark, but today took that dip.
Well, I'm going to tell you, I'm like any other weatherman or weather girl or whatever you want to be. I just look at the 10-day extended thing and look at it, and that's what we go with.
Yeah, you do like just do what most of the weather women do out here, and just, you're wrong, push your tits out.
Hey, I got a rack.
That's what I'm saying. Push them out.
Push them out there. Hey, you can watch them now. That we're live.
You can see him.
You can see him. I'll put that hairy nipple out there. You'll be able to check it out.
He's got a plunging V.
It's funny listening to it in the morning. I'm getting ready, and I turn it on because we want to hear ourselves because we're egomaniacs. No, we just want to make sure it sounds okay.
I just want to make sure it's on.
No, that's not probably why. But we listen to it. I'm listening to it, and Jimmy and I are actually, we message each other back and forth. It's on. This work. It's like, wow.
Well,
first of all, you're thinking something like, what are you doing listening to yourself in the morning? And they don't know. Because we converse, we want to know it's right.
Well, and you know this, most of the time, this is the first time I'm hearing the replay. I don't listen to the shows.
See, but I do, though.
I cut them, and I pop them on. I'll pick two or three, maybe, and I'll listen to again. But it'll be a week later. But 90% of these shows I have not listened to since we went live.
Now,
so when I hear them again, I'm like, oh, okay, cool. That sounds good. Oh, boy, did I suck there. Oh, Jesus, what were you doing, Roy? But it's still fun. Like today, we had the replay with Sam Ridley, and that was 2 years ago, and that was a blast. His buddy Marcus called in. Yeah, they're
the
all
blanket
fun
stories.
Yeah, all fun shows. So that's Monday through Friday, 6 to 8 a.m. for your morning drive. Hashtag morning drive. Hashtag talk radio. I'm learning all these basics. I was talking with Julio and Dennis about this. basic hashtags. Don't make shit up.
Oh, so my made-up shit doesn't work?
Oh, yeah, same here. Mine is hashtag Jimmy time. Oh, who cares? No one.
No, but see, if you do enough of the hashtag you use, then see, that's where we're going to end up one day with a trending hashtag all
our
own.
We're not close to being a, you know, hashtag. No.
Hold on a minute.
What is
the
hashtag? You might be a redneck. Hashtag get her done. I don't think we got that clout yet.
But here's the deal. We throw in all the normal hashtags.
Yeah.
And then we slide a little our own little hashtag in it. So they kind of like come in by default.
Well, sure. You get used to it. Absolutely. Like I said, we had Sam Ridley this morning. Tomorrow morning we have the lovely Nika Simone. Wednesday, Ryan Reeves. On Thursday, Sean Williams and Carlos Escobar came by about a year and a half ago. That is a hilarious show. And then we're going to end Friday, start your weekend off right with our show with the multi-talented Johnny Gold. And that's all Monday through Friday, 6 to 8 a.m. right here on chaoticradio.com.
So if you're looking, I just put up the link. You can, if you're watching, doing the Facebook thing, you can look it up there, your phone, whatever it is. So you can watch us live. I did see, don't watch live and listen at the same time. They're like not on the same thing. I got confused for a minute a second ago. I thought I was like in a reverse parallel something, and I hadn't said a word that I thought I said that I was supposed to say about something I didn't know yet.
Well, it's like standing in, I can imagine it's like you're standing at the store and you see the security cameras and there's the back side of your head, or there's the front side or CVS where they keep going, you know, going back and forth. You know,
yeah.
Recording in progress.
And here's the thing I don't like about it yet, and I don't know. I'm going to just peek right now. All right. We see the bottom left camera shows a lot of the back of my skull.
That is your backside. Yeah.
So it's like I'm going to adjust my headset to block the spot.
Well, you know, you're in good company.
I am in good company. Here's the thing. They're shaving their head to do it.
Well, I'm just saying, though. You're in great company. Real
Let's
quick,
bring
though.
Him in. Go ahead.
No, not yet.
Go.
I got to...
Go, bring it.
Real quick, though. We have our Legacy Room show coming up in May. It's a Mother's Day show, May 13th, Chino, California. We have a hilarious Elizabeth Owen returning. Monica Nevy is coming back for a third time, a Legacy favorite. And our headliner for the evening... The hilarious and talented Gayla Johnson. And that's going to be Mother's Day weekend, May 13th, Legacy Room. Tickets are available now. Go to legacyroom.com or Facebook Legacy Room, and you can pre-purchase tickets now. This one will be a full house.
Yes, it will. And so, hold on a minute. We got to use the Chino Chuckles, Ladies of the Legacy, with the other hashtags.
Oh, absolutely. We'll mix them in.
All right, as long as we know. So come down to Chino, check us out.
We'll definitely mix them in.
That night. Cook, Jimmy.
Sir.
Can they come in now? What are you... Look, he's over here watching himself on freaking... freaking Jack, dude.
Well, on the YouTube page, there's actually a live chat window. So if you got any questions or anything, I got that right here. So we can definitely answer your questions. If you're too shy to call, I understand. But if you're not too shy to call, 909-360-8330. I'm looking right at it too, but I still don't have this number down.
Well, you know what's bad? I'm listening to the replay shows, and it's the old phone number.
It's
on
the old
a lot
phone
of
number, yeah. I wanted to keep Blaine's promos in there, just because you know the Blaine's Humble Show.
Yeah,
yeah. I wanted to keep those in there, but you know
what that is?
Yeah,
it's retro.
It's retro. It's the Blaine Humble Show 8 to 11.
No,
Monday through Friday with the replay immediately after.
Yeah, so you used to have the replay before.
Yeah.
It was 9 hours of that shit.
9 hours.
That's all right.
Yeah, so we can't do 9 in the morning, but you definitely got us for 2.
Yeah, 2's good. It's 2. We already said it. Monday through Friday, you got 2 hours a day, plus a 2-hour spot on Monday night, plus Chaotic and Coffee on Sundays, I'm sorry.
Sunday morning, 8 o'clock.
So that's a lot of Roy and Jimmy. Add the hours up. That's 10. That's 14 hours of Roy and Jimmy a week.
Exactly.
We're pushing for 16, just to let you know. All right, let's bring him in. This is our third time guest, right? Third time?
Yeah. Third time.
Third time. We got Mr. Dennis Vargas here.
What's up?
Nothing, man. How are you?
He's not even on the air. Am
I
in?
There you go. There I am.
You were here the whole damn time, but you were watching yourself on your phone as you were talking at the same time. Turn that shit off.
I was trying to multitask. That's what it was.
All right. And then we have Julio Gonzalez here, too.
Because you're white.
I wore a Dickie shirt so I'd fit in with you.
Oh, there you go.
Freaking
Orale.
Orale. Yeah, I got some Mexican heritage in me from down there.
Yeah,
my mom, remember we talked about
that.
So don't start no shit.
Orale.
I can mow your fucking lawn if I need to. I don't do.
Hey,
Julio, talk to us.
Right here.
Subway.
That's it.
I know that's why you were talking about the other thing you do. I know why. That's why you haul them freaking shirts.
That is why.
Now, these guys barely said hello, and we already have a phone call.
All right.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, so we're just going to pop that right through.
Let's pop them in.
Hi, guys. Here's a call. All right. You're on the Roy and Jimmy thing.
Let's go. Oh, no. No, they're here. They're trying. You're talking to the other side.
They're breathing heavy now. Did you pay your bill or what?
Line one, you're on the air. Let's go.
And we're gone. That was quick, though. I thought you guys, that your was, fan base was
I
like...
I think that was my mom.
Your fan base was like breaking the doors.
Well, I'm going to tell you right now, it was a 509 area code.
That was no, it's my dad. That's why he's missing, so I haven't heard from him.
That's Washington that State, so time. If you guys, you know, you guys been up in that area.
You been up there before? You got any kids you don't know about? I don't know what's happening.
I hope not. I pull out, man.
This is not the way I want to find out.
My pull-out game's on point.
All right. Dennis, your third time here, buddy. Welcome back, man.
Hey, thank you. I gotta start getting paid for this shit, dude.
So do we.
Yeah. we're all waiting. And don't even... Now, see, why you got to do that? Now you got Julio not even... had no... nothing to look forward to, but now he's wondering, there's money?
There is. What's the...
Was there money? Where's the breakdown on this?
What's the medical, you know, 401k
you guys got to offer? You keep the drinks, I got the door, how's this working?
Exactly. We pay less than scale.
Oh, there you go.
Isn't that thing they pay when you have to do anything? You got to get at least that if you're part
of this. I think if your role has under 5 words, then it's like the cheapest I can come in on this.
Right. You know what? You said too much. Shut the hell up now.
Hey.
Laughing's okay. No more. That was laughing's okay. Hey, just put you over the top. It's enough. No. Don't you think I'm not going to now? I like Julio. I've seen it before.
You know what? He gets that a lot.
I know. I do get that a lot.
Right.
I do get that a
lot.
Do
you really?
No.
Right, no. I'm saying.
All right. Last time you were in here, Dennis, you had a Cholo Fest.
Cholo Fest,
The first Cholo Fest.
Yeah, it was a great show. We had, I think it was over 200 people. We had a lot of sponsors. It was a great, great show.
And you had on the show here, you had in studio here, Ann Flag
and Cochino.
And Cochino Red.
Yeah.
And you guys, that was just a fun group there.
Yeah, it was fun.
And then you guys went ahead and rocked it over the MTL in Riverside.
Yeah, at the MTL. So this time around, we had a venue, but we're getting a different venue. And we brought along Julio. Julio is part of the Cholo Fest crew now.
Yeah.
So, I mean, this time around is going to be a lot bigger and better.
All right. 509 is trying again. You want to give him a go again?
Yeah, let's give him a shot.
Let's
all
try. Right.
What's 509?
Maybe they got something about Cholo
Fest. All right. 509, you're on the Roy and Jimmy thing.
We're getting closer.
We're getting closer.
I think they're running. Are they running from something?
All right. 509's done. 509. So, yeah. So, you got a new venue coming up. New name, you said?
Yeah, let Julio take this right here.
Julio, welcome. We're
only taking this because he forgot already.
Already?
Right? No, I
forgot. Like, we just agreed upon this like at 8:30. And he's like, what's that name again? I just said it.
HomieFest.
There it is. Look
Homie
at that.
Fest.
It kicks in. After you give him some, you give him some stuff.
I'll remember after a couple lines.
You got to like mouth it out to him. He's like, Julio, you're Julio. I got it. Okay.
Thank God. we had to change it because a lot of people thinking, oh, I go to Cholo Fest, I'm going to get shot. And we want to bring all the races in. So we just said, all right, Homie Fest, how about that? All the homies can come in. You don't have to be Mexican to be a homie.
That's the only reason I didn't come to the last one.
Yeah, that's why you didn't come.
That's why I didn't come. No, I wasn't.
Because
now you can.
Now you can. Because I think if you came to the last one, everyone would have thought you were the owner.
But you had a good turnout, though. You said you had a great turnout for Cholo Fest.
Yeah, the first one we had over 200 people.
Yeah.
We had a lot of great sponsors and everything. So this time around, I think it's going to be a lot bigger and better.
Yeah.
Especially bringing Julio along, you know, with his experience and everything. It's going to be an amazing show.
And
I'm coming in as an investor plus my printing company as well.
Yeah.
You want us to sponsor?
Man, this has got a Godfather theme going on right now. I'm in the trash business. That's all I'm going to say.
The cool thing was, like, when I first called Julio and I was like, hey, Julio, do you want to be on the show? And he was like, cool. And then he was like, no, I don't want to just be on the show. I want to be an investor. And I was like, cool, that means I don't have to pay you. That's the first thing that came into my head. Like, I don't have to pay this fucker then. He's going to be part of the group.
See, this guy don't know how this thing works.
He's still a little confused, right?
Yeah, I'm in the Godfather. I'm actually in a Goodfellas right now. I'm in a waste management. That's all I'm going
to
tell you.
Exactly.
I'm an investor to make more money than just performing.
Do you have a date? Do you have a...
We're shooting for June, right?
Yeah, we're shooting for something in June. Yeah. We're still looking at different locations because we actually do want to do like a big event.
Like a big festival.
Yeah, have the car show thing, like guys selling corn and chopped up fruit.
Now I'm in.
Fucking yes, right? Yeah. Come down and eat corn, bro. It's going to be great.
Like a real festival.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Like out of a shopping cart, too. We're going to make it like, right? We'll make that home, that good
genuine
straight feel.
Yeah. Okay, now we got a call, but it's 9:09, so I think we're going to be okay with this one. So we're going to pull our first caller just because.
First.
All right, you're on the Roy and Jimmy thing.
Yo, do you live close to the 509 too?
They had the same intro.
Okay, so we're taking no calls tonight.
No calls tonight.
So, did you guys pay your bill?
No, they're coming through, so I think it's the people you know are having a hard time speaking into the mic.
Somebody's getting shot.
I remember when I was
talking about Cholofest.
I remember when I was overnight at West Valley. I know I can call out, but no one can call in, so I don't know if this is that situation going on.
Oh, West Valley, so you got locked up then?
Yeah.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, so I know I could call out, but you had to pick your time.
Now he can relate to you.
Yeah. Now we got a relationship.
I just got my VIP pass to this shit. No, that's cool, man. So you're shooting for, you know, a good size with the car show, almost a carnival thing a little bit, just to kind of kick it off a little bit. You're looking at a park? You're looking at where's your vision on this?
Well, because the guy that we partnered up with, Cazal, I think he's listening. He should be in a lot of prayers and, good wishes go out to Cazal. He's not here tonight. He was supposed to come up. But he didn't come out tonight. He just had surgery, so.
Oh, okay. I was wondering. I'm like, is he sick?
What did I miss? He had his testicles surgically removed, so that's why he's not here tonight.
So he just got married?
The fuck?
Pretty much.
He just got married. Is what you're telling.
So that's why he's not here.
Well, you know, if
because he has no balls. So
these two guys grew up together, so they constantly give like. Just,
oh yeah.
Let me get this straight. We've been on the air for 10 minutes with you, Dennis. You've been on the air 10 minutes. You've already dogged Julio, your investor.
Yeah.
You're giving a shout out to the guy with the venue about his balls being gone. Yeah. This is going to be big.
This is going
to
be awesome. This is going to be awesome. Huge.
Pretty soon, me and DJ are going to be in here talking.
I know, right?
Well, let me show you how this. Let me show you how this works a little bit. We're just going to teach you a little bit. Okay.
All right.
Hey, we have sponsorship availability here on our show.
Absolutely.
Anytime you'd like to come in, you are a guest in our home. As a matter of fact, if you want to come to my home, you're welcome to my home as well.
If there's,
you see how that shit works.
If there's anything my family can yours.
Wait.
I've known Julio for a while. We've done a lot of shows together.
At least 45 minutes confirmed.
You couldn't even remember how he changed the name a half hour ago.
Yeah. I'm surprised he knows that he met me before.
I know, right? I knew you when you were fat.
Remember,
we were both fat.
We all got something in common.
I'm still fat.
Yeah.
There it is. Yeah.
Yeah, you got two things in common.
You're at the before stage.
Here's the bad thing. I've already dropped like 200 pounds.
Well, see, that's good.
No, it's not. Because you lost a ton. You both lost a lot of weight. I've lost that, and I'm still fat.
Yeah. You're halfway there.
Halfway, dude. I'm done. I'm ready to get a cheeseburger.
Guys. You want to try 909 one more time?
It's not really. I told that fucker to call in.
Okay, we're gonna do one more time. Third time's the charm.
How his nuts are doing?
Third time's the charm. All right, 909. You're on the Roy and Jimmy thing. Hello?
Oh, shit.
909, you're with us.
All right, we're done. We're good.
Okay.
Something's wrong with your phone.
No, man. You can hear them.
Yeah?
And they're not even speaking. Yeah. And you can hear them, like, walking with their phone in their freaking...
I'm thinking that's your ex, bro.
Someone's
checking. Someone's trolling your shit right now.
Yo, did you check in here?
Oh, I did.
There it is.
Oh, it's yours, fool. It's yours. Don't blame me, fool.
Hope someone's watching your shit. Hope someone's watching your shit.
I'm not the way. This guy's like blaming me, and it's him.
It's like I used to check in everywhere. I mean, once in a while still, but everywhere I went, I'd check in except for here. So I wouldn't check in here because everyone knows I'm here for like 2 hours.
Mm-hmm.
You have no idea if I go somewhere, I check in and out, I'm gone. But here, 2 hours, I'd come repop my truck while I'm sitting here freaking on the air.
Yeah. I can't check in because of Donald Trump. Because then I'll get deported.
They know where he is. Yeah. They'll throw him over the wall.
Dude, they know where you're at anyway.
I keep telling him he's not that special.
I know.
Donald Trump ain't going to start with you. He doesn't
know you exist.
You'll be on the last bus, bro. You'll be on the last bus.
I'll be in the back. Wow, that's racist shit.
Save him for the last. He's not doing nothing.
You didn't listen last week. This is not racist, Jim.
Oh, okay. What happened last week? Tell us, Jimmy. What happened?
We went multi-denominational last week.
Really?
Yeah, it went off the chain, man. You gotta look that one up.
Who was here?
Oh, it was just us.
Just us.
Oh, really? Just us. And that explains it because you're both white.
Yeah, you guys can't do it by yourselves. You need someone else.
I don't know what happened. I just kind of was on a rant.
You need.
We had callers in. We're being polite because we can see you guys eye to eye. But man, if we didn't look you in the eye, we could be off the shit right now.
And I know, even though it's, I know.
But you need a different race to like balance it out.
I know, even though it's Homie Fest.
Yeah.
You fuckers still know Cholo Fest because shit could go down.
Well, that was the whole thing.
But because I'm like, Homie Fest, don't fool me, either one of you.
That's what we're hoping for, though. I'm like, hoping to fool a lot more.
You're not fooling me right now. I know you guys go all of a sudden from Homie to Cholo in a minute when I start talking too much shit. Hey, I got my Dickie shirt on.
See, oh, there you go. Hey, no, wait. You said you're part Spanish.
Yeah, my mom.
I remember that. Yeah.
Barreras.
My mom. There my grandparents is. spoke Spanish in the house. Huh. And I failed it in high school.
Yeah.
It wasn't right? Even you wouldn't see that. Looking at this big ass white boy right here.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's the first impression, but, you know, under the layers.
Under the layers, there's a lot of layers.
Shit's genuine.
It's genuine.
Yeah. So I can't be a what is it when you're a reverse coconut? I've heard coconut.
Reverse coconut.
But I'm backwards. I'm white on the outside, brown in the middle. A coconut's brown on the outside, white in the middle.
Well, they call that a mounds, right? Is that it's a reverse coconut?
A mounds. There you go.
Is a nut or without nut?
With or without nut, I don't know.
Who knows? Have you been locked up before?
No, I have not. I haven't.
And you have no nut in you.
I have no nut in you.
No, that's the other guy. That's the other guy.
Wow, this is getting dirty.
You're sitting here. It is dirty already.
I know, right?
Right?
I gotta get checked out.
Right? Are you trying to watch yourself on TV now?
He is. You can't talk to him.
He like, can't.
He catch your attention. He's like, what? Are you talking to me? What, I'm watching myself.
He's answering a question from 3 minutes ago.
I thought you were my friend, Dick. What the fuck?
No. He's an investor. Yeah, completely different thing than a friend. He'll teach you something else right now.
It's going to take him a while to remember that.
I know, that's right? Yeah, what was the show called again? I forgot.
HomieFest.
HomieFest.
It's night. You won't get shot at HomieFest. You come and make a new friend.
You know, I thought of HomieFest per se. I thought of Homie the Clown.
That's what I thought. Yeah. I thought Homie the little characters.
Yeah, so the homie characters.
Yeah. That's pretty cool.
See? Yeah. So it's going to be fun little clowns beating you with the big old dirty sock.
Exactly.
And so many people.
I'll be the guy taking your ticket.
And so many people say homies. That's a great name. You know, the white kids. Yep. Fuck my homie.
Yeah, exactly.
It's got. No, that's perfect, man.
I was hoping to transcend. Yeah, bring everybody in.
Transcend.
But you can check us out on Facebook with ChuloFest Comedy Series. We'll change the name to...
Yeah, he jumped the gun on that one. He's
like, I bought the website
now.
I bought the website already. I took all the cans down and sold them. Bought the website. I'm a GoDaddy.
I tried.
For a year.
Got a year at Cholo Fest.
You know what? They give me money off when I saw about 8 years of Cholo Fest.
Well, you didn't have a rough turnout or anything. It's just the name preventing you from getting the venue?
Because, I mean, ideally, we would love to take it around everywhere.
Sure. I mean, it's a great hook.
Exactly,
I mean,
you got the font.
I mean, it's perfect, actually.
We're just trying to make it more commercial. So gotcha. Like somebody outside of Los Angeles can also understand what it is.
Gotcha.
And especially because it's not just like a regular show. Like, a regular comedy show is like, you got a host and you got like 3-4 comics and headliner and bam, that's it. But with like Cholofest, what we did is like, we had the car show, we had like vendors, we had people walking around during the comedy show.
Like a festival.
Yeah. During the comedy show, selling, you know, tamales and ice cream and just like trying to make it like really ghetto. And
in a good way.
And the
warm fuzzy feeling.
So kind of, right? so really kind of like a street party.
There it is. Pretty much.
There you go, Jimmy.
Right. Exactly.
Because we were playing around with the neighborhood theme too, like something that we can make it seem like a good old block party.
And the first one, I mean, it had a great turnout. Like I said, we had over 200 people for the first show. It had a lot of great momentum, and people were just talking about it. You know, people were hitting me up after the show, like. Comics were like, hey, you know, when's the next Cholofest? You know, can I get on it? Whatever. And I was like, you know, so it's picking up momentum. So I'm thinking, you know, especially bringing Julio on and you know, with Cazal and just the group of people that we have, it's going to be a bigger thing than what we initially thought, you know. So it's going to be great, you know, just, but we had to change the name because we wanted to get a bigger market.
Well, you know, that's a great sign, though. You had the first one. You had a great turnout. Yeah. But right at that same time, probably that same night, you went, you know what? This could be better and a little different, too, at the same time.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. So, you know, it usually takes people, what, 2-3 shows. The fourth one goes in the shitter, and you go, you know, we need to change it.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. But, you know, to see it early going, you know, this thing, what a great turnout, positive. You got nothing but positive from everybody. And you're already ready to take it to the next level for number two, which is just awesome.
Yeah.
You know, it's just, you already say, you know, this is great, but guess what? Next one's going to be better.
Exactly.
You're making it more of an experience instead of a show where you got to sit there and watch.
Yeah, and that was my initial idea, was not just to have a comedy show, but to have like an experience for the audience, for the audience to participate, you know, in the show. Like, that's why we had the, you know, the vendors selling stuff during the show and everything, because we wanted people to leave and be like, oh man, this is a great show, you know, Cholofest is awesome, you know. But I mean, it's going to be great.
I don't know, man. You had me locked in at corn, so I'm good.
Corn.
You said
corn.
All them street vendors.
Yeah, you said corn. Yeah, corn, Roy was in. No problem.
That gives my mom something to do because she sits at home bored, so she could be selling ice cream, paletas, and
fruit. Fruit with some chili powder.
See, I like that shit. So I don't know if we talk about, I just made it for Easter. I make the wipe the huero elote.
Oh, okay.
So I make it in a bowl.
Uh-huh.
Off the cob.
Yeah.
And then just pile it with butter and mayonnaise and all the shit you put on the corn put it in. So here's the deal. When I eat it off of corn, you can only go so fast to get it in. When you've been in a bowl, you can use the biggest spoon as you freaking want.
You can jam it all in there.
Oh, are you kidding me?
That's what I like about it. He's more about, like, how do I get more in?
Right?
This corn on the cob thing's too slow.
It's great. It's too slow. I'm fast enough. And I'm done with one, and it's like, what, I got to get another one?
I have seen the videos where they hook up corn to a drill.
See the guy lose his teeth?
Dude got jacked up.
No. Yeah, this other girl got her hair caught in it and just bald spot right on top of the head.
Oh my God.
We should have a corn eating contest now. I think it was.
Hey.
Gonna turn it.
HomieFest.
Oh, yeah. Gonna turn it carnival like a little bit now.
I think so. I think so, yeah.
That's what we want. Free pregnancy test for all the young girls. You know? Because they're all gonna be like, Latinas. Hey, you never know. They could get a free pregnancy test. There you go. Yeah.
All you gotta do is just pass out some Plan B's, man. You're not gonna know.
I know.
There you go.
You're gonna have a Planned Parenthood section at HomieFest.
Hey, come on.
You're gonna have a booth for them. Yeah. Come on. Sign up for Planned Parenthood.
And you gotta go in a little door to where you don't know if it's gonna be to go one way or the other, so that way no one knows where they came
exactly.
out of.
Exactly.
You wanna call anybody out on that shit.
Nobody gets protested at our fest.
Right?
Hey, Trump's not coming. He don't give a shit about you.
Like, we're the last ones on the bus.
I'm going to be on the back of the bus.
Selling corn.
You'll never know what it feels like to be in the back of the bus.
You talked about racism.
And he has a car. Why would he be on the bus?
Did you see it? He just shut us all up for like
three seconds, right?
Know where to go.
Stupid statements will do that. They just have me stunned.
It's like he just told you there's a landmine right around here. You're like, foot up.
I like where everyone's and you,
everybody's been quiet.
Well, at that moment, I'd like to know if you could just pull that little thought out of everyone's mind that just hit them, that made them stop before they get there. It's like, no, nah, I'm gonna lay back a minute.
You're like, yeah. Wow, that's fucked up.
He just shut us all up.
Are we going back?
Is that me?
Yeah, that was you, man.
Somebody oh, that's right. That's our live time, replay.
That's your live replay. That was that thing. I'm talking about something I didn't know about that I knew, but I forgot.
Y'all heard yourself back in time for a moment there.
I thought you were playing something like as a bumper to be funny, and I realized it was us. Yeah.
It was right before the DeLorean hit 88. We're about to send you guys back for just a little bit.
Oh,
speaking of, that's a great movie.
Back to the Future? Did you just see it?
I know. I'm just saying. Excited. It's a great movie. It's a reference.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh,
okay. Look at me like
that. It's just a reference.
What the fuck?
Oh, man. That was one of the odd things. Let's go. That was a great movie from 30 years ago.
That's a segue I've never heard of right there. Speaking of Back to the Future.
That was a great reference. That was awesome.
That was a good I did pull that one pretty good.
You did right? Good there, Jimmy. You did good.
Yeah. Don't look at me like that. What the fuck? That was Jimmy.
I didn't look at you. No, that was.
No, you're the one that confirmed it.
I think we're all taken back at your jubilation to Back to the Future. We don't see you as the Back to the Future kind of guy, the fanboy there.
Great movie. I love 80s movies. They're awesome.
Yeah, that was a great movie.
Yeah.
But with the excitement you said it was awesome. Like you saw the opening last night was a thing.
Me and Roy actually went and saw it premiere weekend when this shit went out. Yeah.
Did you really?
Oh, for sure.
Wow.
Funny enough, we just finished drinking that night and said, what do you want to do? Let's fucking go see the movie.
Let's go see the
movie. Wait, you were drinking?
We drank.
You motherfuckers were old then, right?
Yeah, pretty much.
Dude, 30 years ago.
If you were drinking in the 80s, that's...
Yes. You know, that's why I said you weren't even born yet.
And I think the drinking age might have been 18 when we were doing this shit. So we were,
really?
Yeah, we got the skirt early.
Oh, no, man. It wasn't 18. I don't think they even checked then.
No, Arizona was 16.
No, Arizona was 18.
18. Yeah, that was a good state.
Went to Arizona.
That was a good state.
That was a good state.
I moved to Arizona when I was 18, and I just moved out of California into Arizona. I was legal. Like that. Man. I was like, that's a great move. That's a great move. Except for when you can mix that up with a little Everclear. That's not a good move. Never mind.
Everclear? What the fuck?
Oh, man.
All right. We're going to take our break here soon, but we actually have a question for Julio when we come back.
All right. Oh, here we go.
Yeah. Yeah. So
since it's Julio's first time.
It's Julio's first time.
Be gentle.
The show.
Yeah, it's not for me.
Oh, on the show.
He has
been locked up before. So
we got a request here saying, hey, you got to ask Julio something.
I see it right there. He was going to bail, though. And right about now. At 10.
That? I'll stay for the question.
All right, stay for the question.
Oh, no, we got 10. We'll do the break, boom, bam, answer the question, get the hell out.
One, bam. All right.
You know why he's leaving at 10? Because he checked in here. He's like, I got to get out quick.
I got a big old Subway sticker on my car. They know what it is,
man. Right on, man. You're listening to Roy and Jimmy Thing here on chaoticradio.com. We'll be back with Roy, Jimmy, Julio, and this guy, Dennis. All right, see you in a minute. Welcome back to chaoticradio.com. I gotta let Jimmy out of this thing. Watching the video because it's a little delay.
Yeah.
I looked at myself. I sat down. I sat at my computer, and then a video popped up. Like, man, I even sit down like a fat guy.
I saw. Well, you know, I saw you do that. Your arm came up and everything. I was like, that does not look good for radio.
Oh, the rabbit hole goes deeper. Tell him.
Well,
don't
here's
stop
the
there.
Shit. And then I go, and then I'm telling Julio, this is my favorite part of it. I go, yeah, my girl always give me a bad time because I tie my shoes like a fat guy. And he knew what I was talking about because he used to be a bigger guy. But that wasn't the best part. The best part when he goes, oh, yeah, I remember that.
Sure enough, he showed us his shoes and they were tied to the side.
And she gives me a bad time because...
Well, she's giving you a bad time because all that grunting she wants to hear on her, not on your shoes.
My shoes. My face starts turning.
You're more vocal tying your shoes.
And she gives me a bad time because now what I try to do, and I didn't this time, obviously, because I showed Julio my shoe and he goes, ah, yeah. But I'll tie them after the third attempt. I'll tie them just I tried to put my leg up on the table. It took like three times. Oh, that was probably great to watch live. Yeah. Shit, I gotta watch that back.
Well, that's gonna be next week we're gonna have to like start the show with Roy, like Mr. Rogers, you fucking tying your shoes on.
When I get in?
Exactly.
So she gives me a bad time because I tie my shoes just to the right thing. To where I can just slide them in and on and off, even though you tie them. You don't have to untie them. Yeah. Well, if I do them that way, then I tie them in the middle, so that way now I slide them in and out. No one has a clue. But I go, babe, here's the thing. They still look at me. They know I'm still a fat guy, not just by my shoes.
Yeah, they didn't have to look at your feet going, oh.
Makes sense now.
Well, I see.
I get it.
Oh, you're right.
All right, well, we're back. Roy and Jimmy thing right here at chaoticradio.com. Give us a call, 909-360-8330. We got Dennis Vargas and Julio Gonzalez in the studio.
What's up?
We actually have a question for Julio. It's from a viewer. Name is Sean Williams.
Oh, shit. Sean Williams.
Sean Williams, this segment of Ask Julio.
You didn't know this was a new segment,
I'm going to need to get paid if this is a regular thing.
If this thing catches, he's going to get paid more than us. Today's episode of Ask Julio is Ask Julio about the racist joke applause break on Saturday.
Oh, shit. I want to hear about this.
You have our attention.
We were doing a show at the VFW, right? And it was Mel Austin who was on stage. And he goes into this.
That's Mr. Squeaky Clean.
Yeah, Mel Austin. Mr. Squeaky Clean. Yes, that's him. So he does this racist joke, and for the life of me right now, I can't remember it. But he set it up by saying it was a bad joke. But it ended up getting an applause break by the audience. They loved it. So I went over, looked at Sean, and we just started laughing. He goes, I can't believe they got an applause break.
You got your A-game shit. This is going to kill, and it's quiet. This is a shitty joke. And
that's basically how he set it up. He goes, this is a horrible joke, and he says that they loved it. They ate it up. you should stick to racist material.
You can get away with that. You did the pre-setup right there. You know, now this is racist as hell. Brace yourself. Yeah. And they just fucking hungry for it.
But you know what? Some crowds love that racist stuff, though.
Oh, hell yeah. They do.
Well, you know, it wasn't mean racist, right?
Yeah.
No, I don't think it was mean racist.
Yeah, if it's not
but
mean
is
racist.
Any, but is there nice racist, really? But
you do the setup like that, you know, you kind of already got them.
Is there nice racist?
Yeah, nice racist would be Roy getting hard about the corn at HomieFest.
He did get hard, didn't he?
That's a good joke. What is a nice racist joke?
You should have listened last week. Yeah. I don't know. My girl just hit me up and says, maybe we should get you Velcro shoes.
There you go. See?
That's really fat.
Now we can go one step further. We can go old and fat and get New Balance Velcro. I think I heard New Balance is the old man's shoe.
We're going to chip in for some shape-ups.
Some Skechers. I just looked down to see what kind of shoes I had. And I realized I looked down, I couldn't see them.
Oh, wow.
Wait, hold on. I got to hold a breath.
we've been there.
Skechers. Is that okay?
It's okay.
I'm just checking.
You got to roll.
We have been there.
We've been there, bro.
Oh, because wait. Out of everybody here, everybody here has lost weight, right?
Yeah. Yeah, actually.
Oh, wow. Like an extensive, got that in common.
Yeah, extensive amount of weight.
Yeah, I lost 45 pounds last year.
Oh, wow. There it is.
I lost 60 pounds. Julio, you lost a lot of weight, too.
140. Not 200, but yeah, 140. Damn, so man.
And Roy?
About 200.
Yeah, that's awesome, man.
Jesus. And I'm still the fattest fucker in the room. Shit's not right.
Wow. Right?
I started at 495.
Wow.
No, shit was, it was real.
Big.
Wow.
And it... Looking back, it pisses me off. I should have waited a week. I should have, because I could have went
you
to a
started
big,
at the wrong week.
Right.
Is there a festival going on?
I could have. I could have went just pushed it one big barbecue season in the season. I could have said we're just starting $4.95. Everyone's like, wow, that's a lot. What if someone's would start? I started at 500 pounds.
Yeah, people, 500. That's more impressive. Yeah,
but
that's
$4.95,
like half a ton, bro.
$4.95. I was like, yeah, well, you know, you were almost there.
Yeah, four something. I don't care. Five. Yeah,
whoa.
You're right. A hero. Right. You are a hero.
Yeah, your impressive scale was 5 pounds off. You totally lost the crowd.
So I'm wondering now if I just go back and put your back up to five and then go down again.
Yeah. Yeah, I do that every year. I get higher and higher. When I don't lose weight, I just raise the starting point.
So next week, you were 496.
Yes.
Okay, next 3 weeks later, 497. Slowly creeping in on us.
Well, see, that's better than what I was thinking. I was thinking I gained all that shit back and started over.
Yeah, okay.
No. And it's a bad thing because everyone here lost weight. It's like that Rodney Dangerfield thing in his Back to School when he goes, you feel fatter? Get fatter friends. Right now, I got fatter friends that are skinnier now, and I'm the big guy.
This is how we feel better.
We asked Roy to show up. You and your straight, tight shoes. Fucking Julio. This guy's a beast. I mean, I did shows with him years ago. We did Ontario. We did a couple shows.
Oh, yeah.
This guy is a freaking beast. Seriously,
thank you,
dude.
Bro.
Seriously.
Thank you so much.
Had a good time with you.
I love making people's faces hurt.
Yeah, that's good stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, I don't know if she's listening. This is just shout out for her. Don, remember the Subway shirts? Okay, this is the dude. She'll go, oh, yeah, that's him.
Subway.
The Subway.
Freaking love that shit. Have you ever caught any flack for that?
No, never. But
I wondered.
Dude, that's been my moneymaker for a long time. Yeah. I would definitely say I'm over 70 grand since I started that.
Wow.
Damn. Since I started that t-shirt alone right there, it's been responsible for a couple meals. Right?
And they're not as expensive as they used to be. No. Look at it, be all skinny.
Yes.
Yeah, I remember the first time I met you.
Uh-huh.
At Mariposas.
Oh.
Benny Mena show.
Yes.
It's not even there anymore.
Yeah. Nope, not even there. Yeah, I was like about 360 at my highest right
there. Yeah. Because you had that one joke, and that's the one thing that I always remembered, with that one joke where you said about people giving you directions.
Oh, by fast food places.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah. Oh dude.
I do it all the time.
That was so funny.
It's true.
It's like I said, like my fat ass can't remember a street.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I was like, wow, that's such a funny ass joke. But that's when you were bigger.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's true. Ask me where something's at. That's how I'll tell you.
Oh, yeah. No,
dude, you run to McDonald's, a left, you're going to hit Taco King, make a right, it's right on the corner.
I did that joke when I was in Texas, and at the end of the show, I was outside, and this couple comes up, and they're like, what do you got going on here? I go, oh, it's a comedy show just finished, now they got a regular club, and they're like, oh, we're going to 69 Bar. I'm like, where the hell is the 69 Bar? Dude turns around, and he goes, you go down to Wendy's, and you make a right. There was two people that were the audience in that show, and they started losing it. They're like, oh my god, you're serious? Like, yeah,
it's true.
And then the guy's like, what do you mean, what did I do? I go, Bank of America's right there, fucker, like why didn't you tell me go there first? And then they go, right.
Hey Dennis,
why'd you pick Wendy's?
Dennis, I just Facebook messaged you Roy at $4.95. It's when we first started doing open mics.
Oh, shut up. Let me see.
Actually, you know what? If we first did... If it was first...
Oh,
that's,
wow.
That's a lucky strike.
But yeah, it then?
Yeah.
That wasn't $4.95 because I had already started losing weight. I was probably down about 60 pounds there.
Oh, shit.
Oh, wow.
You see that picture, Dennis?
Yeah. Wow.
So I was probably 60 pounds down there.
Send it this way.
Send it to everybody. Put that shit up everywhere.
Yeah, copy it. I got this
picture of my old driver's license and you one side by side.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, holy shit.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Like, wow. The first one looks like I just ate my parents.
No, I had my old one for such a long time, and I would start to get mad when people don't tell me anything. I hand them my ID. They look at it. They see me now, and they're like, okay, here. I'm like, really? You're not going to say nothing?
That's a lot of shit.
It doesn't even look like me.
No compliment,
it
nothing.
Doesn't look like me, officer. Take me in.
I used to have I had my driver's license picture for so long. I used to have a full beard and longer hair, but it was all not gray. God. So I had it up until last year. I looked like a freaking terrorist. And they don't let you wear your glasses. Right? I always mean mug my picture. You know, because they always say smile. Why are you going to smile? Because my thing is on that is if you're giving up your driver's license, it ain't a good thing. Yeah. What's going to, you know, basically 90% of the time, that's not a good handover.
It's not a happy moment.
So I mean mug it. Well, this year I smile and it looked like a, oh, it's so bad. It looks like I ditched the wife after 50 years and went gay. It's like I'm just this happy old guy looking now.
I thought you were gay.
Well, I'm not happy. So
that's the difference.
That's the difference right there.
All right, yeah, and then, the catch 22.
And their flash bleached out my face and brought all my white out in my hair. I mean, it looks nothing like me.
I had a customer come in the other day, and I don't know how it was on driver's license, but he showed me his driver's license picture.
Yeah.
They let him take it with a hat on.
Oh, really? Oh,
shit. I'm like, dude, how did you do that? He's got a Raiders hat on as he took his picture. I'm like, dude, how did you do that?
Not only is it a hat, it's a fucking Raider hat.
Right, right. I was blown. Dude, you can't do that. He goes, they let me do it. They went to take his picture, and he said he went to. I said, how did you? He said, I didn't know I was getting my picture. I just came to renew it. And they said, now I can't. He said, my hair is messed. I can't. And the lady goes, I'll leave it on. And took the picture. I said, wow. If they ever take that, you need to keep that forever. Because that doesn't happen.
No.
I had a friend that showed me his ID, and he was cross-eyed in it. And I'm like, how'd you do that? And he goes, bro, you got to commit as soon as you walk in. As soon as you walk in, you got to cross your eyes.
I should have done that because mine says, you know, must wear corrective lenses. But you got to take the picture without your glasses. I should have totally went freaking cross-eyed on that.
As soon as you pull them off, let that eye just go.
Just let it wander through. Right
through. Go back. Tell him you got to change the address.
Could have done it Steve Cooper style.
Exactly. Oh, my God.
Oh, shit. Sorry, Coop. That's all right. I'm your Newman. You didn't give a shit.
Just remember, commit, all right? Because the guy taking the picture, he ain't not going to believe you at first.
He's not going to believe you, no.
This guy's
jacked. You got to commit.
I've seen it a few times. A guy did a YouTube video about where he goes to the restroom and he's in the handicap stall. Have you ever seen it? He goes and he's looking around. All the stalls are filled up, right? And it shows him in there. He's looking around. He's like, oh, and the handicap one's open. So he goes in there. And he goes in there and he's sitting down doing his business. And right then you hear the door open. And he sees a couple wheels roll by.
Oh,
right? And it's like, oh, shit, man. I'm in here. I'm in this guy's stall. What do I do? I'm such an ass. And you see him just sitting there. And he flies open the door. When he's done, and walks out all fucked up. And he walks through the bathroom.
Oh, no.
You gotta commit, bro.
Real quick though, Julio, your first time here, and how long you been in the game, man?
Oh, it's been over 9 years. This January coming up, it'll be 10 years for me. So I'm finally getting them 10, you know, double digits.
It's been more than that, no?
No, I'm pretty sure it's been 9.
it's his fucking story. He knows when it started.
I'm going to make it up, all right? Relax.
Right there. Nah, man, you're wrong.
I'm surprised he remembered that.
That part he remembers.
Right? There it is. I remember you're wrong.
I remember
you don't know what the fuck you're doing there.
Oh, yeah.
I found the driver's license picture. There it is.
Look at that. Even blocked out everything.
Oh, wow. Show it to the camera.
Oh, yeah. Well, I don't even know how to do that.
Look behind you.
Well,
you
I don't
look
know
angry.
What, that's what I said. It looks like I just ate my... Oh, it's on a delay. I could be holding it here and no one sees it. Look, I'm like this. Whatever. You'll
so
get it.
So 9 years. Okay, nice. My question. This is a great question that I always ask comics. What got you into comedy?
You know what? I mean, I've always been that funny guy, and I was at a Christmas party, and there must have been like 9 women surrounding this table, and I just had them dying. At this point, I was going to comedy clubs religiously, almost every weekend. That was my escape.
To check out shows?
Yeah, that was my escape. And it was the guys that suck that were like, I'm like, I can do this. Yeah, they gave me confidence at first, and then that table of women, a couple of them were waitresses at the Ha Ha Comedy Club. And they're like, you should do it. So sure enough, that was in December. By January 17th, I hit the stage for the first time. And I did like an open mic before that, and they started letting in the regular crowd for the shows in there. So I had like about 40, 50 people I went up.
Was this at the Ha Ha open
that
mic?
That was at the Ha Ha, yeah.
Yeah, the only time I had
the original Ha Ha.
Yeah, you're like, well, you had to pay $5. Like,
you got $5. You got, what, 5 minutes and a beer.
There you go.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, you got a beer? Shit.
Yeah. Jim. Well, so the only time I had a crowd when I did the open mic there is because they always end up being fucking last.
Yeah.
And the freaking, you know, the lineup and shit. So I always had the crowd coming in trying out my new shit rookie season. Like, ah, fuck.
That's how it got started for me. After that, I think the first show I did there on the 17th, I ended up selling like about 50 tickets. Nice. And then they're like, dude, buy the tickets from us. You can sell them. You make more money. So I started doing that. Second show there was 75 people, and it just kept growing.
Wow.
It just kept growing, yeah. So I'm like, maybe I got something here, you know, to go on, do a show, and walk off with like 350, I think I got.
Oh, shit.
For that night, yeah. And I'm like, this is my third show. I'm like, I'm going to keep doing this.
I'll keep doing this for sure.
Yeah.
This
is
working out. So you don't need our shitty internet radio money.
Well, no, he doesn't.
No, but it helps.
Basically, it's like Monopoly money, it's I can give you some shit.
It's not that shitty. Man. It's going to hurt me or nothing. Right? Well, my God, I'm not going, man. I heard you on that radio show.
That's a great story, like hearing how comics started.
How it started, yeah.
How they started, you know, what they do. You know?
Have you told yours yet?
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, he has. Well, you know, it's one of my favorite questions on the show here. And, yeah. But, you know, and everyone thinks it's hack and cheesy because everyone does it, but I don't care. I like knowing the roots.
Yeah,
like,
exactly,
you know,
yeah.
What got you, the balls that get you to step on that stage, and everybody's first time, I think we're at like 97-98%, everyone fucking killed.
Yeah.
Their first time up.
Yeah.
Because you're so wound up. I got like my first showcase at Lovitz when I went up.
Oh,
and they were calling me they were calling me a video game, the Duck Hunter, because I was this side of stage, like Chris Rock, this side of stage, that side of stage. I was just so wound up, you know, and I said, okay, back it down. But now I look back at some of my first shit going, man, you had some energy. You got to bring that shit back. You know, you're just wound up and out there just saying shit. I mean, everyone kills their first time up.
It's such a rush.
Yeah, and I would, like, I look back at the jokes that I used to do when I first started, and, like, I would never do those jokes again.
You know,
I would never do them again.
We've talked about this. I'd like to do a show with people we've been together a long time with, and everybody do their first fucking set again.
Yeah.
Because right now, because we know stage presence, we got timing, mm-hmm. You know what I mean? But do your very first set, you know, and we'll probably just slay that shit. We all shelved it because we thought we sucked. You know, but you go back and you listen to the bits instead of the presentation or whatever. It's like, fuck, I got to bring that back.
That's a good one.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Right?
We wanted to push it one farther. I want to do Jimmy's first set, and I want him to do mine.
We all just swap sets.
How Jimmy lost 300 pounds.
Yeah, exactly.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah, it would. You guys know Scott Shimamoto, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I did a show with Tony Ariola down in Whittier. And real low turnout. I mean, it was so low. And so we're just up there freestyling. And I end up starting doing one of Scott's bits. Just because there was
tell me you did his Japanese people.
He was sitting in the back.
God.
He was sitting in the back, and he was trying to make the moves on this girl. And
that's funny enough.
And
is this, is this the same Scott?
Yeah. I'm freestyling because I don't want to burn my shit up here. So... all of a sudden, I go, whoa, what can I do next? And then I went like this, Chinese people.
Oh, my God, that's awesome.
The son of a bitch stood up, hey. That's mine.
That's mine.
Oh, funny.
Said, prove it.
Prove it, right?
Yeah, I looked at Tony. I said, I'm running the light, dude.
Oh, that's awesome.
Chinese people.
But see, everybody has to have that one joke.
Oh, yeah.
That one joke that people will remember you for.
Oh, absolutely. Bro, sometimes it's like a favorite song.
Yeah,
yeah,
you know,
exactly.
Like, I'll do shows and they're like, dude, do that bit.
Yeah.
I want to hear that bit. I brought my friends so they can hear that. Like, they want
to. We had a great story from the comic Brett Ernst. Okay. He said he came down and he headlined Pasadena. Killed the show. But one of his trademark bits was, I don't know if you guys remember this, but he was roller skating.
The Tony bit.
Tony bit. You know, so,
no, never heard
so
of
funny.
Fucking classic, right? But it was his fucking trademark when he started. Huh. Well, he didn't do it. He had new shit, right? So after the meet and greet, this couple, they came down from Fresno to see him.
Oh.
And they said, oh, you know, we love that bit. Too bad he didn't do it. He took him back inside. They turned the lights on for him, and for fucking three people, he did the entire bit.
That's awesome.
That's a great guy right there.
Yeah.
That just proves that he just does it for the people.
Yeah. Well, and that was his thing. They traveled all this way to see me do that bit. Yeah. I didn't want to let him down. Let's go.
Yeah. You know, and
that's awesome.
We all get tired of our bits because we say them all the time. We get bored with them. But then if you leave it out, you know, I've had people say, oh, you didn't do the thing.
Yeah.
The one part.
Yeah. Like, I have a joke. It's the possum joke where I talk about like old hood rats and stuff like that. But. Yeah, I love doing that joke. Like, I've had people that I've met, not even at shows mm-hmm. where they would come up to me like, oh, I remember you from whatever, whatever.
Right.
And they would start telling me my joke back to me. And I'll be like, dude, that's fucking awesome.
I did a show with this one guy. The only time I saw him was one of the open mics at the Haha. Mm-hmm. And I saw him as a La Luna show with Victor Vasquez. And mm-hmm. this guy goes, Jimmy Shaw. He goes, oh, you had that. And he recited my fucking bit.
Oh, no way.
And I'm like, holy shit. Now I felt like I need to do this one now. So like, when I went outside. I'm
no,
like,
but that's a great feeling.
It is.
That's a great feeling.
Especially, you know, when you're bored with your set going, oh, God, I'm going to do this again. And then, but like I said, so what I started doing is my new shit comes off of tags from an old bit. Mm-hmm. That way it's there. I'm familiar. I can try something new, tag it. If it hooks, we'll launch off into that one and kind of bury it a little bit, but sometimes you got to keep it in there.
You know what I see that as all the time is like if you're a real successful musician or band or something and you're at a concert and you're going, and I always thought that it would be cool when you've got a whole stadium of people and you just back off and they're singing your shit.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
It's the same thing. It's like someone wants to hear that from you, and then they're so into it, they can even do it.
Yeah.
Sometimes I get self-conscious about that, because a lot of the times I'll bring back the same people to the show.
Right.
And I'm like, oh, I got to give him something new. And I remember doing that, and he comes after me at the end of the show. He's like, bro, I was really looking forward to that. Like, me and my wife love that.
And Jimmy and I fight that. We do a monthly show at the Legacy Room. And we're like, these people come every month, and we want to change it all the time. And we think that. It's like, well, we got to change it, make it different. Then it's like, these guys are like, no, but we like that.
They want to hear.
What do you do, right?
Yeah, the owner, we're telling the owner, he goes, no, people tell us they love seeing you guys. It doesn't matter what you do. And it's like, okay, it's good to know, but I still need to. It's also a perfect venue once a month to change shit, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, that's how we grow.
It's safe. Yeah,
that's
safe enough to try it.
The new favorite bit that you might like.
Yeah. Well, do you guys have a bit that. I have one bit. I use it as my closer most of the time now. But it started out, it's one of my first jokes from my fucking open mic days. Mm-hmm. And it's gotten so twisted, it's not even close, but it's still pieces of it. Is that, you know, the evolution of that one bit, it morphed into this other bit, but it's still the roots of it. You know, mm-hmm. Roy knows which one that is.
Yeah.
And, you know, I love that part of the game, of the craft, you know?
Yeah. I mean, like for me, I have that one joke, it's the possum joke, where I talk about, like, how old hood rats?
That's the only one too. Let them.
That's that's like a 15-minute joke.
I know. Yeah.
Five-minute set or 20-minute set? I'll just make it longer or shorter.
So Julio doesn't know that this is me telling him that he's not going to be part of the Cholo Fest anymore.
Hey. You ready? Ready? He's an investor. He's doing what the fuck he wants.
So Dennis.
So
Dennis's guest set is
you're
one possum.
You're off the show. We need money.
Yeah. So Dennis's Dennis, your guest set is one possum, but your full set, your 15-minute set is four possums.
Yeah.
Wow. No, I mean, but it's awesome as a comic, but not just a comic, but as an artist. That people realize and they remember what you
exactly,
do.
Exactly,
you know, that's a great feeling.
You know, in a small way, like we were talking earlier, kind of kidding around, but in a small way, that's our getter done. That's our, you might be a redneck, you know.
Yeah.
You know, our Chinese people, because that is just, you know, classic right there.
Right?
That's what it is.
We can only strive to be that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
You know, we make fun of him, but you know what I mean? That's his thing. You know, as soon as I said his name, he goes, you do the bit? Yeah, he did the bit.
And everybody knows that joke.
Exactly. Yeah.
That's what happens. Oh, I know you got to get running.
He commits,
You got to get running. Hey, you got, like, 4 minutes?
Yeah, I got 4 minutes. I can hang on.
Since it's early?
Oh, shit. Yeah, we'll do this.
We'll do it.
Dennis has done it probably three times.
Dennis has done it before.
Oh, yeah, we got to do this shit. This is perfect,
that's right,
Julio.
Yeah.
This is perfect.
So he's got to get out of here, but we're gonna pop it early.
We're going to pop this thing early. What we're going to do for you, Julio, here. Every week with our new guests, we do a thing we'd like to call the Roy and Jimmy Thing Great 8 Quiz.
Great
series of eight questions. There's no right or wrong. It's just yes or no, whatever you feel like. You're not being graded. It's not against your score. Your credit will not be affected.
Damn it.
Well, maybe a little.
In a good way,
actually. You lost credit for coming to the show.
So we're going to burn through this before we send you off your way. So are you ready, Julio, for the Great 8 Quiz? Okay, number one, Kimmel or Fallon?
Kimmel.
Good answer. Number two, what is your chill music? What's your go-to?
You know what? I've been liking opera a lot more lately.
Ooh, shit.
I would cook to it. I would go, I just go on Pandora. I don't even know the songs. I'm just like opera. Pandora. Let me hear it.
You know, it's funny because I used to build my cars and trucks and all that.
Yes.
And I would put on KLOS and think that, or KCAL, and yeah, what that is, it got me too wound up.
Uh-huh.
So I drop it down to the coast, or then I went to the wave.
Just and, slowly transitioning.
Exactly. Yeah. But, you know, just the soft white noise shit in the back, you know, jazz.
And you can hear, and we hear good music like that, or something like classical or that kind of thing.
Yeah, it's soothing.
You can hear the highs and the lows and a little this and that and pick it out. No, I'm in. I get it.
Yeah, no, that's great. Number three, comic inspiration. What's one of your heroes back in the day or even now?
Oh man, I mean, you know what? I remember watching Eddie Murphy Delirious.
Delirious.
And to the point where I can watch it over and over and still laugh just as hard. I know the jokes, I know everything, and for me that's been my drive to create a set just like that. Create a set where people can listen to it constantly and still laugh just as hard, because that's what Delirious did for
you
me.
You know, and it still holds up.
The barbecue bit. Yeah. Yeah, the whole thing.
I hadn't watched it Goonie, in Goo-goo. Probably 10 yeah. years. I hadn't probably watched it in 10 years. I watched it, and when I see it now, I laugh now, but it takes me back to the very first time I watched it.
Mm. Yes.
Because it was something I've never ever seen before, and straight-ass hilarious.
Yes.
Yeah, that's a great one. Number four. Your go-to comedy movie. You can pick two if you want.
Go-to comedy. You know what? Hangover. I would say The Hangover, because I remember the first one being hard on the laughs. Like, I remember laughing quite a bit.
Yeah.
I'm watching that one right there. Shoot, if I had to pick another one, I would go to my younger days, man. I remember watching Dumb and Dumber. that would be like the good slapstick Dumb stuff. Dumber, yeah, because yeah. like that's kind of what I grew up on, like yeah. Hot Shots, you know, that good, right, ridiculous right? Gotcha. Stuff. Yeah,
gotcha. Okay, number five. What's the last thing that pissed you off? It could be minor, could be major. What's the last thing?
The that last you thing off? That lazy family member, bro. That's the last
No.
Dude, what sucks is you gotta love them. You gotta love them. But yeah, no, man. They push buttons.
And they know all the buttons.
Especially when you're taking care of them. You know? You're like,
oh, shit. The worst.
There you go.
That's the worst.
Yeah.
That's the worst. Number six, pizza leftovers, cold or warmed up?
Yeah, I'll take it cold. When I was eating that stuff, I would take it cold. Like, it didn't matter, because heating it up just takes longer.
There you go.
Even again, and I didn't do the microwave, because that would just ruin the pizza right
you
there.
You said when you were eating, so you don't...
I don't need cheese no more, man. Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Like, I quit a lot of stuff, yeah. Yeah, the more I found out about food, the more really? I would stay away from certain things. Yeah, because I realized there was no benefit to it. It just tasted good. Like, that's it. It's like you're in an abusive relationship.
My favorite, ready? There's no benefit to it. It tastes good. There's benefit.
Yeah, but that's like the only thing. That's like staying with the guy that beats your ass because the sex is good. Like, it's no.
Damn.
Yeah,
whoa, that's no, a good analogy right there.
That's a good one for a girl.
Coming from you.
Damn. Okay, number seven. We just lost the cheese board.
Oh, shit.
The cheese board is not sponsoring us anymore. Number seven, what's your favorite cuss word?
Fucker. I like fucker.
Fucker. Yeah. Fucker's good.
Shut up, fucker.
You always fucking asking me that.
Yeah, I do. That's hey, my fucker. Favorite. That's why I won.
There you go. All right, this is our last one here. This is our favorite. Number eight. What is your best impression? Everyone has one.
Here you go.
Oh, it doesn't shoot. Have to be a famous person. It could be your lazy relative. But everybody
they laughed too hard at that. Yeah. I
know, everybody thinking, does an impression.
I was thinking, it probably is my lazy relative. One time, I came home, and this guy...
This fucking relative
told me the hot water was hot. He's like, hey, if you're gonna wash your hands, be careful, because the hot water's really hot. I'm like, it's summer, fucker. Why are you using the hot water? Of course it's hot. But yeah, that was and if you knew him, I nailed it. All right, if you knew him, I fucking nailed it.
Solid. Thanks for playing with us, man. That was fun.
That was a strong impression. That thing was solid.
Oh, man. We're going to have to. Thanks for coming, man. You can come back.
Man, I appreciate you. I definitely will come back. Well, fun. This was fun.
Come back when you forget about this guy, because he has no idea what Cholo Fest is.
That's my show. How can I not?
No, it's not Cholo Fest anymore. That's what my whole point was. HomieFest.
HomieFest.
There it is. All right, we're going to get out of here, take a break, stretch your legs, say goodbye to Julio. Right,
Julio, thanks for,
thank you, guys.
Thanks for coming in, buddy.
Catch him everywhere where they catch you. Hey, Julio Gonzalez everywhere. Check Subway.
Yeah, Facebook.com/Subway. All my other media, OG Comedy. So that's Snapchat, Instagram, all that stuff. OG Comedy and Subway. That's how you find me.
Look him up, man. This guy's a beast. Worked with him before, and I'm glad he's here. Have a good night, man. We're going to take a break, stretch out. We'll see you back in a minute, man. That was a lot of mans. That was a lot of mans. My Spanish Harlem Mona Lisa. Welcome back to the Roy and Jimmy Thing here on chaoticradio.com. Last segment. Give us a call, 909-360-8330. We've lost Julio, but we still have Dennis.
Yes, a big shout out to Julio for coming out. We had a blast with him. So check him out. Look him up on Facebook and check his schedule. Go see him whenever you have that chance.
It's funny, we're just talking to him. Check him out on MySpace too, maybe.
Get back to his comedy roots there. A quick reminder here, our phone number here is 909-360-8330. And our very first Breaking Our Cherry on YouTube live broadcast. Nice.
What's up, YouTube?
Go to YouTube.com, search Chaotic Radio, and the live feed will be right there. So you can see Roy, you can see Dennis, and I don't know if you look at your lower, what's that, lower left, the window in the back, there's my hand. There we go. Let's see if I can put
there's
my face,
Jimmy.
Up.
I can
put
see
my face
it.
Up in this shit.
Jimmy's putting his face up in the window.
There we go.
Yes, yeah. You're in there. You know, that just reminded me. It reminded me of they hanging some ugly pictures in this place.
Right? That's my self-portrait there. So
John Knowlton.
This is, yeah, John Knowlton, fucking three fingers.
Three finger John.
Yeah, so, yeah, this tells you the caliber of my appearance that we were live video and you still can't get me. So you are welcome, everybody.
You're going to get Jimmy. Jimmy's going to be coming in. We got the camera coming in there because I'm a little upset he's not on, but... Jimmy will be on.
I'll be on. I'll step in there in a couple minutes and do a curtain call.
Curtain call.
A little curtain call. Bow to the masses and all that. So, all right. So we left off there. Your Homie Fest, basically Cholo Fest Part 2.
Yep.
That's awesome. What else you got going on? What have you been up to, man? Your gigs, life. What's new, buddy?
My next book show is May 12th at Gotti's in Downey with Walter Reyes.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, so I'm doing that show. It's been pretty hard, you know, just getting booked and stuff. So it's kind of comes, like, out of the blue and stuff. So
yeah, absolutely, because you have a lull, and all of a sudden you got six shows.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. So, May 12th, Friday night, Downey Gotti's with Walter Reyes. That's going to be a good show. So
nice. Funny dude. I did a show with him with Victor Vasquez. I think it was over at La Luna.
Yeah, he's a cool, great guy. So, yeah.
Hilarious.
Yeah.
Hilarious. We got you actually scheduled up for a replay the week after.
Oh, yeah. You were telling me about that.
Yeah,
that's
absolutely.
The first one.
The one with Tony.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that was such a great fucking show.
Game show night. I think
loved
had that
it.
One.
That was
there.
Awesome. That
yeah,
was
I think
awesome.
That one's the one that got you in trouble.
That's the one that got me in trouble. But, boy.
How did that get you in trouble?
I got me a gold bid off that one, so I'm good with that one.
Would you rather?
Would you rather?
Yeah. Oh, that was a great episode. I love that. I still listen to that. Sometimes. Naked, I'll listen to that show.
Well, the only way to really listen to a replay is naked.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
That's what I hear. Like I said, I don't listen to them, but when I hear them again, like on a replay, and just to remind everybody, the replays are Monday through Friday, 6 to 8 a.m., your morning drive time, replays of classic Roy and Jimmy in the morning, right here on chaoticradio.com.
There you go.
You like that?
That was awesome, dude.
Nice little segue right there. Company man, Zig.
Company man.
Come on. A little shout out to Zig. Zig from the Zig Zone, a loyal listener there.
But they had a first on a Chaotic Radio.
They did. That's right. Yeah. Zig. Yeah. They christened the ship basically with this one.
Yeah.
How did you do that?
I believe a guest threw up.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
And with the YouTube video, I'm sure that I'm sure that was a golden moment.
That's
right
awesome.
There.
Which chair was it? Just to make sure I'm not sitting in it.
There was one kicked off to the side, but I'm not going to tell you which one it was.
Hey, I'm impressed that we walked in here. It didn't smell like puke.
No,
it
no,
didn't. Yeah,
no, we walked in tiptoeing.
Zig keeps a clean ship in there. So, yeah. But Zig Zone, catch him before us every Monday night, 7 to 9 p.m. Look at me, I am full of Segway promos right
here. Yes, you are. You're such a pro.
I'm trying to be a pro here.
Oh, you're like an infomercial.
I'm like an infomercial here.
You are.
Hey, almost, hey, yeah. Is pouring milk a pain in the ass to you? Well, I've got the solution for you.
This cracks me up. Someone just liked our... We're sitting here. Can we try to keep abreast of anyone talking to us online while we're on? Because we want to respond to them.
Right.
And someone just liked that picture. That is so funny. The one you did founded in 76.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Did you see that picture, Dennis?
Yeah, I seen that. Yeah.
Yeah, that's basically when we met. It's 75, 76 in grade school.
That is actually a grade school picture.
Is that real?
That's real.
Wow. It's very real.
That was awesome.
Look at that hair. I got a lot of it.
Oh, yeah. You weren't shy with the hair.
Damn. I look like Leif Garrett.
Right?
Fucking going back there.
Leif Garrett hair in that one. That's awesome. Jimmy looked like he's ready to go to spelling bee.
Oh, God.
Look at the collar on you, man.
Oh, I know. I was killing it.
He worked it with it had to be a denim jacket.
For sure.
With the big collar hanging over the top, with the lapel over the lapels?
Yeah, the denim jacket, the collar shirts. I was a sweater vest guy. I was probably this close, Dennis, to being fucking Sheldon from The Big Bang Theory. Seriously.
How close were you? Because you're almost there.
I was so nerded out. Right now, I can kind of carry my own in a crowd, but man, deep down, that nerd shit is there.
That's such a great picture, too. You did that. You like? Yes, I love. And how cool it is we're right there next to each other.
Yeah.
Because it would have been tough to do if we were on different sides of the picture.
Right, exactly. There'd be a lot of fill in between there.
But we're almost touching.
Almost touching. That sounds kind of lovely right there.
Doesn't it sound lovely?
It is.
It is, actually. Don't sell it short.
Don't sell it short. It's exactly what it is, man.
Don't sell that shit short. Here, I'm going to send you, Dennis. I'll send you the actual picture there.
All right.
All right. You see that shit is real.
Oh, the real one without the blacked out part?
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Let me see.
He's going to look right now. It's great radio while we watch you.
No, it's video. We can do that shit.
Oh, yeah, we did that.
Everyone already saw Dennis fucking bopping his head to Disco Inferno, so...
Hell yeah.
It's all good. They're soaking in the experience, Roy, of radio with their eyes.
Wow.
Radio for your eyes.
He's looking at her.
That's our shit right there, Roy. That's the tagline. Radio for your eyes. Chaoticradio.com.
That's pretty horrible. You guys, that's like, wow.
Dude, that is some on-point shit for the time and era.
Yeah, I guess, it is. You guys look like molesters for...
No, we were probably molested. We were young.
You probably were molested.
And we probably still have no idea we were. That's still subconscious shit for another 5 years.
And it was just like, that's just the way life was then. I mean, you just, hey, man.
Well, back then, yeah. It's either you were molested or you were a molester. Yeah.
Now it's not politically correct.
Yeah. Now it's like, whatever. You know?
Whatever.
Whatever.
So, you know? What are you guys crying about?
That just meant that just meant the priest liked you.
Yeah. You know,
yeah.
No. Speaking on that subject, I used to be a bouncer at a gay bar, and I never got hit on.
Was that your nickname, Bouncer?
No, I wish it was.
At the gay bar? Or you
I actually was a bouncer at a gay bar, and I never got hit on. And I got pretty offended by that shit.
Well, sure. You got to figure the odds. I mean, when I go up to San Francisco, I get looks.
Yeah.
I know I do. Yeah. It's awesome. I'm more popular up there than down here.
Right? Yeah.
Yeah.
And I was like, I work out. What the fuck? At least I want to be able to say, no, I'm not like that anymore.
Is it like, you know? It's like Julio with his driver's license? You ain't got to say nothing?
Yeah, exactly, right?
I'm not like that no more. Yeah, no more was the thing. That's the part
I was, but not anymore, you know? Like,
so you just threw it back on them. It's like, you were hotter. Maybe I would again.
Exactly.
But you're not. But thanks for the compliment. Yeah,
exactly.
I've raised my standard since then.
Yeah. I'm not like that anymore.
Was there English in that freaking thing? I like that.
I'm not like that anymore.
What? You couldn't even say it when you thought about it.
I did think about it.
Oh, that was the problem.
Yeah.
Just let it come out. Feel free.
And that was the thing. It didn't come out.
Oh.
And that's the awkward silence.
There it is again. That's two. That's two for the show.
That is two of them.
Jesus Christ. That's two for the show.
Are we done yet?
Are you? Are we almost there? You're not funny.
The Chinese people.
Not a
Chinese people.
Gotta set it up.
Is Scott still alive anymore?
Yeah, he's out there.
Hey, checking. What happened to Dennis? Didn't he? He didn't call in.
Oh
yeah, Garshak.
Garshak, yeah. What's up with that?
We're worried now.
Damn,
Dennis, you all right?
He may have only missed like two shows.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. Maybe that wasn't him trying to call. I know it wasn't because that wasn't the number. We'd have recognized it.
Yeah, he didn't call in.
No,
I was waiting for that.
Hey, Dennis, we just want to make sure you're okay. We're feeling bad.
Yeah, tap twice on your screen.
Knock three times on the ceiling if you... Tony Orlando and Don, that's before your time.
You say that, but then when you play it, people know it. You're like, what?
Twice on the pipe. Is it something like that?
Yeah.
Oh, I wasn't sure. It just kind of came. It's one of those things that's in your memory that it's like, wow, where'd that come from?
Yeah, it's one of them songs people know, but they ain't going to say it out loud until you play it. And then they go, that's my shit, especially if they fucking drink.
There it is.
Oh, there you go.
So see, it sounds there, a little.
He's
little
doing exactly what I said.
He did.
Hey, girl, what you doing down there?
Whoa.
Dancing alone every
what
night.
What you doing down there?
I live right above.
Wouldn't you want to know?
He looked at the camera.
I know, right?
That's awesome.
Oh my God!
Here it comes the hook's coming, man.
Here it comes.
All right, word is.
Oh my darling, knock three times on the ceiling if you want me.
Come on, come on.
Twice on the pipe. If the answer is no.
Twice on the pipe. First he says, what are you doing down there? And then he says, twice on the pipe. You know what? I got news for you. If she's knocking twice on the pipe, the answer was yes.
Right? Yeah. Or she doesn't know what she's doing.
Could be interpreted in so many ways right there.
Yeah, exactly.
What did we... Oh, is that Teddy Bear song? We thought that old trucker song? Where we really thought it was like touching, and then we listened to it after all these years, and this guy was weird.
I think it was Trucker Matt went to the molester part of it, right?
And it was. He was just talking about this little guy on the radio. It's like, oh my God.
Oh, Billy, I'm just going to have to clean up now and see you next year when I come through.
Yeah, it's bad.
Not that good. Sounds pretty bad. Yeah. That sounds horrible.
These old fucking songs.
That shows you our mentality.
Speaking of these goofy ass songs, Dennis, you got a guilty pleasure song.
Guilty pleasure.
We all have them. There's a couple songs like where if I pull up and it's playing, I'll change the station or take the fucking make sure it's not on when I go into store because you know if I get like shot and killed, I don't want someone going to my car going, this motherfucker's listening to Hanson.
I don't know. I think it'll probably be like something like heavy metal.
Yeah,
like something by Guns N' Roses.
That's not guilty pleasure.
I mean, but that's like,
I'll give you guilty pleasure. Ready?
What's that? What's that?
We had a dance off to this.
Oh shit!
Dancing Queen, like ABBA. That's guilty pleasure.
That's pretty out there.
It's out there, but everyone knows it.
Yeah.
And if you're alone, dudes are fucking gonna be bopping their head to it.
It comes
halfway through. You
look
get the goosebumps.
You're bopping.
Yeah.
Halfway through, you get the goosebumps and you're fucking in.
I got to tell you right now, if you were bopping your head like that at the gay bar when you were a bouncer, you'd have got some.
We had that dance
off. I probably would have had some, yeah.
We had the dance off with Zig, the dance challenge.
Yes, and Zig sent us a picture of him in the shower.
Yes, that's right.
See?
This is pretty awesome. I can dig this.
See? That's a guilty pleasure.
Okay.
That's a guilty pleasure.
Now you got a guilty pleasure in it? No, he's still going to go with Guns N' Roses.
Yeah, I'm still going to go with Guns N' Roses. So.
That's like, not guilty.
I can't think of one, though.
Come on, you're like, welcome to the jungle. That's not guilty.
Okay, guilty pleasure, I would think, if I assume for you.
Okay.
Looking at you, it's first
raining.
Impression.
It's raining men.
I can see like it would be a surprise, but not a surprise guilty pleasure like a Christina Aguilera song or you know a Britney Spears song, shit like that. You know but you didn't know you knew. So when it comes on, you're like, I know the song, but you're not going to tell your bros. Dude, I just heard that.
I guess Selena.
Okay.
There you go.
Okay. By Selena.
Yeah. Oh, that slow one too, right?
Yeah.
Do you cry during that one?
I do pick up a couple tissues.
Here, yeah. This is the one I already picture you fucking crying to. All by yourself. This one just make you fucking cry. This is Dennis weeping.
Do you want to make me cry? Is that... Oh, there it is.
There it
oh
is.
Oh, my God. I'm going to cry.
We just touched his soft side. Because every rocker has his soft side.
There you go.
Every cholo has his soft side.
You listen to this on the way home tonight, just fucking knuckling on the steering wheel, fucking tearing up. Why'd you leave me? We could have had something.
I loved you way, what the fuck?
And then you hear Julio, fucker.
Julio's probably crying right now, too. You motherfucker, you got me.
He's like, I'm glad. No, he's probably like, Subway.
Right now he's like, I'm glad I'm not in the studio anymore.
Yeah. I loved you, fucker.
There it is.
I thought we had something, fool.
I thought we had something. That's fucking hilarious.
I guess that would be the guilty pleasure.
See, there you go.
Hey, Roy, there you go. Roy, is your computer plugged in?
My computer?
Yeah, you audioed up?
Yeah, I can.
Cool, because we got like 10 minutes. I'm going to go sit in the studio with you guys.
Okay, come on. Come on, right, he's cool. Going to come on in. All so right. I got to turn our live video mute on. So there we go. Jimmy's coming in. This is awesome. Oops. Okay. We had to plug in. Sorry about that, because Jimmy's coming in here. You know, I wonder if I can find...
We're going to live video.
Guilty pleasure sign. Now Jimmy's in.
Am I on?
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Turn me on here, bro.
You're sexy.
Am I here?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, there you go.
Hi, my name is Jimmy Shaw, a longtime listener, first-time caller. It's your dime. What's your beef?
So I'm looking right now the 50 awesome guilty pleasure songs we're ashamed to like but not tell anyone.
All right, hit it.
I hope there's no ads in here.
There's going to be a couple. Hit mute first.
I'm working on it right now.
As an engineer, Roy.
We should have started this a while ago. I'm looking right now.
No, we started late. We got another 10-15.
Okay, here we go.
Sorry, Dennis, you're not driving home yet.
Cool.
All right, guilty pleasures. What number is this?
Well, that didn't work. I closed the button and nothing came out.
Top 10?
It's top 10.
All you guys are professional.
No, not really, because nothing's playing.
This is why there's no live video for me in there.
Right.
Yeah, see, it's not playing. That's Don't Stop Believing. That's not a good one.
That's not a guilty pleasure. That's guilty an anthem. Pleasure. It's Everyone in stadiums and shit
yeah,
now.
Exactly. Yeah.
Which kind of sucks when they put them... Okay, these commercials now, they use like all our old classic songs and shit.
Yeah.
Like a couple years ago, I don't know what the commercial was for, but it was September from Earth, Wind & Fire. It's like, is nothing sacred. You can't touch that
shit. You can't pull that shit back down anymore.
Yeah, no. You can't make that a commercial. And then they have, like, Volkswagen was doing heavy metal songs. You know, Judas Priest commercial for a fucking Volkswagen. I'm like, no, that's
you know
evil.
What, you know what's bad about it?
That's the devil music. That's our shit.
The bad thing is I freaking love that.
Remember when I bought, what was it? Motley Crue. There you go. Shout at the Devil.
Right.
I bought it at Licorice Pizza,
great
dude.
Song,
yeah,
man.
I put that album in. I got it at Licorice Pizza. I put it in the bag, and I still lived at home. I hid it so my parents wouldn't see it. That's how fucking devil music shit this was.
Playing. Oh, well. We're going to try it, but it's not working. Auxiliary's not working.
Aww.
Well, let's take this time to give shout-outs to people and then...
Do some shout-outs.
No, I'm going to... All right, you there we do go. That one. Wait, here it comes. I found it. That's a guilty pleasure, they say.
I don't know what this is. Oh, move it. The only time I know this song is from, Madagascar.
Yeah, but you think it's funny.
I've never seen that.
Oh, dude, it's fucking hilarious.
It is really? Funny.
Good?
I think it's going to work. I think it's going to work now. You know why? Because I muted our live feed, so it muted everything.
Oh, gotcha. All
right, so,
guilty shout-outs, Dennis.
Shout-outs. Let's give a shout-out to Mission Tattoos, which is our sponsor for Cholo Fest.
What's up?
Awesome.
What's
up, people. Mission great. My brother gives the piercings there, so if you want to get a piercing.
Prince Albert?
Whatever you want.
Pierce Albert.
He could touch your dick if you want.
Prince Albert.
You know, he does the piercings over there.
He does the piercings. Pierce Albert.
Ah.
Sorry, we're having a moment while we're talking.
He got confused on my joke.
Is that what it was?
Yeah. He played a little wordplay.
mclimby@juiceplus.com. They're another sponsor for ChuloFest.
Nice, nice.
So, you know, check them out. They're for like a juicing thing with get healthy and stuff, you know.
I think we got that in the title.
Yeah. I'm not that healthy, so I'm kind of like whatever, you know.
So you if, know? You, if you said oil changes, I was damn.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So and what else? What else do we got here? Oh, I want to say what's up to my girl. So she's listening.
What's up, Dennis's girl?
Annabelle. Hi, babe.
What's up? Subway.
I know she's there. Subway.
Subway fucker.
What's up, fucker? Go to sleep. You got to go to work tomorrow.
Guilty pleasure song.
What we got?
Oh, there we go. Oh, wow. I love this song.
I knew it. No, I didn't know it. I was just
gonna... I'm not in it.
Yeah, you do. I trade my soul for a wish. Pennies
and dimes for a kiss. I wasn't looking for. Oh, it sounded familiar. But now you're in my way. Your stare was holding. Ripped jeans, skin was showing. Hot night wind was blowing. You don't know who this is. You're going, baby. Oh. Hey, I just met you. Fucking call me maybe. But here's my
number. So call me maybe. Oh, in the camera.
Oh, hell yeah. At your
baby. Look at.
Did I do that instant look up? So call me maybe.
Hey, I want to dance to this shit.
We are.
We are, Dennis.
You're not.
Okay, we're good there.
Oh, that was good, though. Guilty pleasure.
Guilty pleasure, sure. Oh, come on. You got it.
You got it, right?
Oh.
Look at all. Oh. Yeah.
This is like 80s shit right there.
This is it.
Yeah, mid-80s. Damn. This little white dude. We're no strangers
to love. Get it, Jimmy.
Oh, there you go. You know the rules, and
so do I. With that big old yellow trench coat. You see Zig dance this shit.
Computer just locked up on. Computer locked up
on Rick Roll.
Look.
Oh, look, yeah,
the whole thing locked up. Well, you gotta listen to the whole
shit. The rest of the show is this song.
There you go.
That's crazy. It locked up. Nothing will work on the computer right now since it came up.
Locked up on Rick Rolled.
Oh, it's gone now. Whew. I thought my computer was like, look, yeah. The whole thing.
And that was a guilty pleasure up until a few years ago, but then that shit started showing up in commercials, and now it's like, popular, you know, like nostalgic, you know? He was in that Target commercial.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. So now the song is popping up. Now it's like, you were around when that song came out? Yeah.
All right, here's another
one. Doesn't that make you feel old?
This is kind of
does, yeah.
Right?
It kind of does.
Like when you start.
But I don't listen to a lot of new music, so when I hear that, to me, that's only just a few years ago. You know, that's still kind of close enough for my library, you know, my shuffle of what mm-hmm. I got going on.
But not just that, like, for my regular job, like, I work in a jail.
Right.
So I book people that were born after I graduated high school.
Oh, shit, yeah.
And I'm like, what the fuck?
Dude, the people I work with, guaranteed they're half my age.
Yeah.
Half my age.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's like, it's kind of a trip, and then it's not, you know?
We got the next one.
NSYNC.
Oh, what the fuck? How did you know that?
Guilty pleasures. In the video where they stomp.
How?
Yeah, that's right. The marionettes.
Do it for the camera.
The marionettes with the bye-bye-bye.
There you go.
Jimmy's going to do it now.
There you go.
You see the partner.
Let's turn to Jimmy. Jimmy's going to reenact it.
There you go.
I see it. It's been a long time.
All right, let's see.
They're on the train. They're jumping on the train. Chasing the girl.
Here we go.
There's the marionettes. Bye, bye, bye. Bye, bye. Don't want to be a fool for you. Yeah, I've never heard this song. Never heard this song ever.
Right? Never heard it. Uh-oh.
Never, not once.
Never heard the song.
Okay, I want to make sure it wasn't going to go.
Oh, you gotta love this song.
Right? Oh. Look, it makes Dennis go. Everybody's got
Jitterbug.
R.I.P.
There you go.
You gotta watch the video and do it at the same time. Yeah, I can't jump like that.
Should have been with you instead. Wake me up before you go,
go. Believe me, hey. Such a happy song.
So happy.
Yeah, definitely. It plays, you have to dance.
See, that's a guilty pleasure.
That's a guilty pleasure.
Not some freaking other shit. Oh, we gotta say, see, I'm on the ad this time.
Ah, see, but you were ready for it.
I was ready. I got the button over here. I'm doing.
There you go. Skip ad.
It's guilty pleasure right now.
That's old school right there, too.
Oh.
Yeah.
There we go.
These are pretty decent songs. Not so much guilty pleasures, I would say. Maybe the NSYNC one. The Call Me Maybe.
Yeah.
Call Me Maybe for sure.
Yeah.
That's just the black and white cartoon, that sketch, which was fucking awesome when that shit came out.
It was awesome. Let's see if I can find one more good one before we go out.
One more good one.
And Dennis,
good one.
Dennis hit us up. He says, I'm late, but what is this live bullshit? I can't.
Have him
you
call
can't
in.
What?
Where has he been?
You can't what, Dennis? I can't
it's,
find
it's
it.
Not that, it's not that hard, Dennis.
Right?
Roy's got the link.
I put the link up. You can watch it there. But don't watch both at the same time.
Yeah, parallel.
I don't know if this is a guilty pleasure, but I really like this song.
Oh, absolutely. I was singing it. What the fuck?
Sorry, well, we're almost out of time.
I was singing this shit.
Dude, I was...
What do you got?
No one listens to that shit unless you listen to Rocky Movie.
Yeah, it's not a guilty pleasure. That's a badass song.
Oh, you think so?
Yeah, I think it's just a badass song.
Oh, we need a better list then.
If you want to take out the whole show with something good, take it out with something good.
With some what?
Something good.
Yeah, I'll take us out with some good. Guilty pleasures, though. I got one. I share this one with Derek.
Tell me.
Molly Crew.
I share this one with Derek Murray.
Come on, something with Molly Crew.
Give me a heads up. I think for you right now.
Shut up. You know it is. You already know it is. That's why you said, oh, no, you're going to cry again. The son of a bitch needs some tissues.
Which one?
I share this guilty pleasure with our buddy from Jack of All Nerds, fellow comic Derek Murray. We have a few guilty pleasures in common.
You think this is it?
Oh, this is a guilty pleasure for me.
Oh, my God.
Turn this shit up,
man. Coming.
I'm gonna cry. I love this song. I love it. Dennis. Listen up. Right? But this is shit. You're by yourself in your car. You just turn it up and you're fucking in it. You're in it.
Every day is so wonderful.
He's in it. So beautiful. Her voice is angelic.
Oh, God.
You dicks. You both are in it.
No, yeah. I wasn't all about that. Oh, shit. I forgot this video.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I know it's video and all, but I gotta go back. Okay. Oh!
This is when she looked all dirty. I didn't... her look, I don't really dig then, but the voice.
I am beautiful. No matter what they say, words can't bring me down.
Everyone's in now.
He's in now.
I am beautiful.
See, guilty pleasure.
Yes, words can't bring me down. Oh, no.
And then the shit's gonna build up, kick in. To me, that's a guilty pleasure.
Crescendo.
Are you going to be a front man on this one, too? The hype man?
Hype man. No, this is not a real good one to do it with. Oh, sorry, we got to go up.
Yeah.
and now you're gone.
Trying hard.
That's a guilty pleasure. And then, but that's a guilty pleasure, but I think the ultimate guilty pleasure for, like, dudes of our masculinity or our era would have to be, like, a Britney Spears song.
That was one, I was one on the list, and I went away from it. Yeah. It was on the guilty pleasure one, and I wasn't sure where you would go with it, but I'm going to pull it up. It's right here.
It's like, what, Hit Me Baby One More Time, one of those kind of things.
Yeah, it would, yeah.
Or
was
a Katy Perry song.
Or maybe a GT.
Oh, that fucking guy's good, though.
Yeah, no, yeah, come on. That guy's
a stud.
Awesome,
though.
Yeah.
No, he's
good. Yeah, I got no shame getting busted, like, listening to that one.
That guy is like...
Britney Spears, though, I'll be turning that shit down. Mm. What are you
unless
doing in there?
Unless you're by yourself.
Well, yeah.
If you're by yourself, it's all the way up. There she is.
Dennis found you, fucker.
What?
Dennis, he found us. Found you, fucker. Dennis!
Guilty pleasure number two.
Number two?
Well, this is just the one. I was going to pull it up. I wasn't quite sure, but you confirmed it.
Yeah, that's a guilty pleasure right there.
Oh, there you go.
Right?
Look at right away what happens to Ed.
Total guilty pleasure right there.
I can
yeah. Right, but it comes on, you're gonna listen to the whole thing. Oh,
baby, I shouldn't. If I'm alone.
Exactly.
But you know what?
Or on YouTube.
Yeah. And now you're right outside. Show me how you want
it to be. Tell me, baby. This right. Grown ass men.
Oh, yeah.
They saw that. I was going to say something, but every now, not this day and age. They got her in her little school outfit. Roy rolls his eyes back.
Oh. Hit me, baby, one more time. Oh,
baby, baby. I thought Roy can't watch this because of the
restraining order?
Yeah.
No, I can't be within so many feet. That's so many feet.
Okay. Oh, gotcha. That doesn't count videos.
I'm making sure. Just making
sure. Doesn't count videos.
Because I've seen his eyes. They got kind of lit up. Though,
so. Right, I have to leave and go do our...
We're going
to
play out on this one, Jimmy.
Oh, play me out on something.
Are we done?
Play
out on this. No,
we're going to go in there and we'll play it out. But I got to play me out of the studio. What do you got there?
I'm trying.
I did it again. I made you believe we're more than just friends. Oh, baby.
Damn.
Grown ass men bobbing their heads.
But it doesn't mean that I'm serious.
Right?
Hell yeah.
Here it comes.
And I gotta drive home for this shit.
Here it comes. Oh, baby,
baby.
Shit, that's a mess.
This is horrible.
No, it's not really.
Yeah, so yeah, definitely the ultimate in guilty pleasures right there. Christina and Britney.
Yep, both of them.
Exactly.
Oh boy. I guess okay. All right.
This was fun. It was great.
How about Shakira? Ooh.
The only thing I know about her is the hips don't lie.
No, they do not.
And the thing and the bad part is I just told you the name of that song.
No, it's all right. We have time.
I always think of her as like our era of Charo.
You know, they're putting a lot of them in. Well, Britney's in here again with Toxic, and Ricky Martin's in here with Living La Vida Loca.
Oh, that is the jam right there. Dennis.
Yeah.
This is all you right here.
Give him that one.
We're going to give it to Dennis. That's it. He's right up his alley right now.
Oh, yeah. I feel a premonition. That girl's gonna make me fall.
That's
this one.
I know this song.
Well, that shit came out though. Nothing like it. The video was fucking just fast paced, fast cut.
Right?
Yeah. Fucking thing was a fucking jam right there.
Okay, we're gonna get up for their big part right now. And then Jimmy, get us out of here. Here we go. You ready?
Sing along. Do this.
Yeah, that's pretty badass.
That's pretty badass, right?
Yeah.
Pretty badass.
Oh, man.
Oh, man. Well, shit. Dennis, third time again. Thank you, man. You hit the third timer.
Third time? Yeah. I got to start getting paid for this shit.
Well, stop. We went over that.
We're in negotiations is what we're saying.
I know. Hey, thank you, guys. I love you guys.
No, pleasure.
Jimmy Roy, you guys are awesome, man.
You guys, you're the best,
you know.
Keep up with Dennis on Facebook, Dennis Vargas, and Homie Fest coming up soon. Definitely details. When you find out more, let us know so we can share.
Yeah, for sure.
And what do you got?
If anything, check out Cholo Fest right now. Cholo Fest Comedy Series on Facebook and Instagram. And we're going to transfer that over to the Homie Fest. But for right now, just check out Cholo Fest on social media. So thank you, guys.
No, I appreciate it. Awesome, thanks, Julio, for coming in. Don't forget, May 13th at the Legacy Room, Mother's Day show. Sorry, my mic just shut off. Mother's Day show, Legacy Room, May 13th with Elizabeth Owen, Monica Nevy, and our headliner, Gayla Johnson. Hit up the Legacy Room at Facebook.com and get your tickets early because this one will sell out. Repeats of this will be on iTunes tomorrow. Replay for Sunday morning and during the week, Monday through Friday, 6 to 8, classic Roy and Jimmy in the morning. Tomorrow, the lovely Nika Simone is our guest from 2014, if you can believe that.
6'2" and some change.
Tall gal. Great gal. We got to have her back on.
Yes.
And I got one more show, Downey, May 12th at Gotti's.
That's right, with Walter Reyes.
Walter Reyes. So excellent. Come check it out.
All right. Roy, great show. Dennis, thanks for coming in. Julio, big shout out.
All right, man. You guys all have a good week. Jimmy, awesome as always.
Here
thanks
we
again,
up.
Man. All right, man. We'll see y'all next week. You guys have a great week. Love y'all. Hit 'em, baby.
A rato.